This is Lorin Parker for Expert Village, and I'm talking about some of the more specialized tools that we have to diagnose and aid our audio equipment. Number one would be the multimeter, which I strongly recommend that everybody have if they're doing any bit of electronics work at all, except for the very, very basics. What it does is this one measures almost all of them usually measure voltage, resistance, and current. And probably the two most important measurements, the ones that I do the most, are voltage and resistance. And then another nice feature is that they also have a mode usually indicated by this little musical note, where if you touch the two leads together, on this one my speaker has gone out, but if you touch the two leads together it'll read a zero, and then if my speaker were going it would go beep, and that lets me know that a circuit has continuity. For measuring resistance, I just turn the dial to the highest resistance I think I'm going to see. So if I think it's going to be between 0 and 20k, I turn it to 20k, and then I measure something, and I'm just touching these guys together, so of course I'm measuring zero. And then if it were to measure something higher than 20K, it would tell me to go higher, and I'd set it up to something like 20 mega ohms and then measure at that point. So essentially we're just setting the precision. We can go down to 0 to 200 within a tenth of an ohm, and then we can go all the way up to 200 mega ohms. And that's actually measuring some resistance. You can see the amount of resistance in my skin is 2 mega ohms right now between these two leads. So I can measure quite a bit of resistance. The other one would be voltage. And here's DC voltage, which is what we deal with the most. And once again, you choose the setting that is higher than the value you expect. So you have 220, 200, 100. If I were looking at something that's supposed to be about 20 volts, I'd set it to 200. If I were looking for something that's about 10, I'd set it to 20, because that's the next number up. Then, of course, one of my favorite tools is portable speaker. Battery-powered speakers are often better than using wall plug speakers, because you can take them with you. Also, there's no chance that any problems could cross over the cable and enter into this battery-powered speaker. And if it did, it's just a battery-powered speaker, so I can replace it easily. Then, of course, if you get more advanced, we have the oscilloscope. This is a portable model, which shows you the waveforms that are present at its tip. And you can actually see the audio waves if you hook it up to the circuit board inside the equipment. These are a little trickier to use, but you can find a lot of information about them on the web. So those are the tools I use the most. Probably the speaker and the multimeter are the most useful, checking voltages and just listening for sounds.